Hi, Mr. Johnson.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, I'm Dr. Gonzalez. It's nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
So, what brings you here today?
I was referred by my unit to get some counseling, you know, for, I've been having a hard time sleeping lately.
Okay. Have you ever struggled with sleeping before?
Well, it's been nagging for a couple of years now. It's been getting worse. Yeah, I don't sleep at all at night.
Okay. Has anything changed recently in the past couple of years from, you know, your younger years that could possibly trigger you not being able to sleep?
Not that I recall right now. I don't recall right now. I just have a hard time sleeping. That's all. I've been a little down too. But most of the time I've been having nightmares sometimes. I have nightmares.
They're just like terrorizing you. Are you sleeping during the day?
No.
So you're just not sleeping at all?
Feels like it. I probably sleep about 2 hours.
Oh wow, mm-hmm. Okay. So not sleeping, if you can give me like a time frame, have you slept like in 7 days, you haven't had a full 6, 7, 8 hours of sleep at all?
No.
Are you experiencing any hallucinations during the day or at night even?
No, not that I call.
Okay. What do you think about when you're awake? What's going through your mind that is not allowing you to just rest and sleep?
I'm uneasy.
You're just really worried
all
the time?
Yeah, I'm worried a lot. Just uneasy, on edge. I feel like more on edge.
What are you worried about?
I feel like something bad's gonna happen all the time.
So, your record says that you were deployed in you were recently deployed. Do you think that has anything to do with your lack of sleep?
Yeah. Could be, yeah.
Are you think you're fearful that if you sleep something bad's going to happen to you? Maybe having some post-traumatic stress from when you were deployed?
Possibly.
Okay.
It's kind of a blur. Deployment is a blur.
Mm-hmm. Are you, do you see yourself having difficulty at work when you're trying to talk to your coworkers or family members? Do you see yourself just very agitated? You don't want to talk to anybody anything?
Yeah, I'm always irritated.
Okay.
My patience has gone very low with people lately.
Is there anything that people say to you to make you feel that way?
Sometimes I don't like when people talk to me in body gestures. That gets me anxious.
Mm-hmm.
And when people raise their voice, it gets me more on edge, you know, because I feel like I get an intense feeling of
like anxiety?
Panic. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see you're struggling with some type of anxiety. I think what we should do is definitely schedule a follow-up appointment so that you could come back and we could kind of talk deeper about why you're feeling this way or what type of things might have happened to make you feel so restless and so uneasy. Right now what we could do is also get you scheduled into some cognitive behavioral therapy, help you figure out why, or help you be able to deal with the people in your life a little better, you know, not be so agitated, maybe help you control your anxiety a little bit more. If you feel the need, like maybe to take some medication to help you sleep at night, that's definitely something we can prescribe you. Also doing some calming therapies before you lay down to go to sleep, you know, try to clear your mind, you know, reading a book or taking a walk, whatever soothes you, going to sleep with a clear mind or trying to go to sleep with a clear mind might make it easier for you to go to sleep. Would you like to try some type of medication to help you sleep better at night?
Yeah, I think that would be good for right now.
Have you ever tried anything before?
I've, I had prescribed Zoloft before.
Okay. Did it work for you?
No.
Okay. I'm going to prescribe you a different medication for now, and then I'll schedule you for 2 weeks from now, and we'll follow up to see how you're feeling, if you've been able to sleep. And then in the meantime, before you leave, schedule also to start some behavioral therapies. Okay?
Okay, I'll make a follow-up appointment.
Okay. All right.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, doctor. How are you?
Good. Why don't you take a seat for me?
Thank you.
And how are you feeling today?
Well, I feel kind of stressed out. I haven't slept well in a few days back.
Are you feeling any anxiety?
Actually, yes. I had nightmares again, so that's why I decided to make an appointment with you.
Okay, and is it the same nightmare you're experiencing again and again?
Yes.
Will you tell me a little bit about that?
Well, I'm back in my country, in Cuba, and everything is devastated. Buildings are fell down, everything is destroyed, and I want to get to the airport, but I'm lost and I don't know where to go. And when I woke up, every time I wake up, I feel like I can breathe.
So I think you're having some anxiety attacks. Are you able to bring yourself out of that headspace when you're feeling that way?
I'm not sure. I'm trying to focus on my work, on spend time with my family, but I can't help to have these nightmares. So I don't feel well.
Okay. All right, so I think your dream might be representing repressed fears of going back to Cuba. What do you think about that? Do you agree generally?
Maybe. I don't know. I'm not sure. I just know that I feel scared.
Okay.
I am scared.
Okay, well, why don't we schedule a follow-up for 3 weeks, and in the meantime, you could try some relaxation techniques, for example, deep breathing before bed, maybe taking a relaxing bath to get you, ready for bed. And we'll see you in 3 weeks.